Hello and welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'm going to dye my hair. But I know I was saying I want to use permanent, but I just remind, this is Demi-Permanent hair color and it's a color 3N, a natural brown. Reading back these instructions, I'm using this Superstar Developer as a 30 volume, but I didn't use it to the full 30 volume strength you see in the video. I'm also going to use some of this conditioner to help reduce the volume of the developer. Right, so 3 ounces of conditioner and 3 ounces of the developer, which will reduce it to 15 volume. Right, the conditioner I'm using is the one that I make. You could always use whatever conditioner you like, right? So the directions are saying 2 parts developer to 1 part dye. So I use in total 3 ounces of hair dye to 6 ounces of developer. Okay, so we're finally going to dye the hair today, right? My hair has been in the this state for a while. So, yeah, I find that. But so, I'm doing is I'm sectioning off the hair with my fingers first. I put this piece away. I'm going to comb out this section, try and get a proper part, and then go in the back, right? So, my hair is dry. I did wash my hair last week, and I just put in some big twists. I comb my hair this morning when I shampoo my hair, and I did absolutely nothing with it for a week plus. Absolutely nothing at all. So, they're just building them twists. So it's not like my hair dirty, but it's not freshly washed, right? So, I'm going to comb out this section and just go and part it with a dye brush. So my hair is in 4 sections now, ready to dye. I have the hair color mixed up here, all nice and thick, because I mix it with some conditioner as well, because it's me and conditioner is a must. Right, now let me put on some gloves, because you know you're going to need gloves when you're dyeing your hair. So you're going to need gloves, you need your hair dye, you need your developer, you need your combs, you need your clips to section off, like how I have my hair in these 4 sections right now. You're going to need a towel to lay down flat, and I'm going to take some cream and I'm going to rub it on the perimeter of my face, because you see my hairline, how it is, it's, you know, it's like a straight hairline, okay? That means the dyeing process, it is not going to be a straight dye process. So I just go and pile the cream, lay it on thick. Yes, I'm going to look cuckoo for cuckoo puffs while dyeing my hair, but that is okay. It is okay. I am home. I see, probably if I was doing somebody here, I doing somebody here, I would not need to do this, but because it's my hair doing, you know. I'm just taking some precautions. So let us recap what we did with the hair dye. So the hair dye is the Argan Oil Demi-Permanent hair color. It is in the color 3N, which is like a natural kind of dark looking brown color, right? And I mix it with some 30 volume developer and some conditioner to bring down the developer to 15 volume. Okay? We have a 15 volume developer, we're using the Superstar developer, right? And I mix it with some of the conditioner that I make for myself, because it's me. It's just because it's me. Anyways, so let's get to dyeing. I am going to start from the front, go back, and unlike bleaching your hair when you're going darker, you start with the roots. Yeah. Okay. In the bleaching, you want to do the ends of your hair first, but seeing as I want to go darker, I'm going to start from the roots. Right, and I'm starting with the top of my hair, or the front section of my hair first. You see, I thought it was looking like a chocolate. It's like in chocolate. I'm going to do the perimeter first. The perimeter of the section. The section's perimeter. I think next time I may not mix with that conditioner, so take, I might put some water in it because I find I was expecting it to be a little more runny. But you know, we live and we learn. So the next time I will mix some water with this day. God, that can get up here already. See how it was looking like chocolate, not cut that again. Anyways, so given my hair density, I'm going about a little less than an inch thick. Right. Now your pattern don't have to be straight, but it have to be clean, if that makes sense. It don't have to be straight like, you know, you're plaiting canoes and you know you want the part to be straight. No, it don't need to be that straight, but what it needs to be is clean. It needs to be clean so that you can get down in the roots. Right, so see, little, almost a half inch. Take. And to not waste product, you just take what is remaining on the brush and press down the hair. Right? And a dip. Make sure you're pressing it down. You know, I think I like this consistency. Yeah. We shall see how the hair pay off though. And I'm just hoping that it's not too thick, that it is preventing the dye from penetrating my hair. But the consistency is very easy to work with, in my opinion, and it's not running all over the place because I hate runny hair dyes. I really do. I do not like it. I do not like it. Most of people like it, but I do not like it, okay? I don't like it because of my hair texture. I know I have to take my time and work through my hair texture. So I would prefer it not be runny and going all over the place before I'm ready for it to reach anywhere. You know what I mean? Because for example, I put it here, I want hair dye here. I don't want the hair dye running as yet. Understand? I want to be able to control. So I guess that's why I do it like a runny consistency. I'm on this side now so you can see. First thing first, the perimeter of my hair. Okay, so far I use one tube of hair dye. I don't know if I'll use the two tubes. One tube is like 3 ounces of hair dye. But I guess we shall see, yes? You see what I mean? A clean part, not straight, it just needs to be clean. So what I'm also doing is when I pull it, I'm pulling the hair a little bit so the hair dye will raise up to penetrate through the section. I'm pulling it and I'm putting some tension and I see the hair dye coming, right? And I'm applying more to this side. Then I'll part it off, like so, like that. Bring it over. Put some tension so the dye will come to the next side. Take the brush, I didn't take up any more product, and help that dye to penetrate through to get the hair dye all over that section. Okay, I'll take a more hair dye, bring it on this side. Parting it off. Some tension. Didn't put any more product on it. Now I'm going to take up some product and apply it to this section. To the back. As you can see, the color is oxidizing, it is getting much darker, which is good. This is what I want. I want it to get darker. Alright, so I'm just going to join up these two sections in the front here as one, and based on how much this container has, I may just need to mix some more hair dye, but I don't think I'll need the whole other 3 ounces. I might need 1.5 ounce of the rest of the hair dye to mix up. But and do the back. I'll mix up some of my hair dye, I'll go on to the back, and I'll do the back. See the front gets black and the back so brown, it's just fit to oxidize and turn black.
Yeah. Alright. But the top back of your hair is brown.
It's gonna get
be
black. It's gonna get black. Make sure I sort out my hairline.
That what you do?
Just on top of
your hair,
what? Well. Yeah, I was missing my dark hair color, so I went back dark, but this time I did not use permanent hair.
What?
Again, okay. Skin.
It got something on your skin?
Time to wash out. Well, it is a bit darker than I expected. But, I like it. Most important, it is very black. Like, it's black, black. It's looking like one. It's not looking like three, it looks like a one. But, I still like it. And I even did my eyebrows. See how long the eyebrows last, because it's mostly dying the skin. That is making it appear so dark. Anyways, yeah. This is it. Now is to do something with my hair. I don't know how I'm going to go with somehow. I'll figure it out.